What I was trying to say is that access to capital was a really big problem. Even today, last year, 2015, I won an award, top young African entrepreneur. Clap hands. Yeah. Top Young African Entrepreneur. It's a program by Mastercard Foundation and African Leadership Academy. It's a prize called Anzusha Prize. So after winning that, I had exposure. I did interviews with BBC World Service London. I did interviews with CNN Africa. I did interviews with how we made it in Africa, Venture Africa, South Africa Broadcasting Corporation. Still, when I went to the bank asking for a loan, they refused. Why? Because I'm 22 and I'm doing agriculture. Wow. So you are young and you're doing agriculture. Wow. You cannot give. And if you don't believe in you, don't trust in you. That's how the bank told me. I gave them everything, my financial progress, everything, but they didn't give me that money. You approach an investor, the same thing. So actually, what the first thing you have to do about access to capital is we have to create awareness and to link these young people, young farmers, and when I speak of young farmers, I mean the farmers at the these people at the age of less than 30 years and who are owning less than 1 acre. So we have to make to create awareness for these institutions that agriculture makes sense and youth can be there into agriculture and bring a lot of money, as they're saying that agriculture, the soil has a lot of money. So the second thing is access to modern equipment, modernizing agriculture. Actually, when I was starting poultry farming, I was using local equipment. But actually, when I transformed to modern equipment, everything changed. When I started using automatic drinkers, I started using water pumps for my farms. Everything changed. So what I believe is that when we make agriculture modern, it will attract a lot of young people. So how can we make it modern? Actually, for example, when I was buying these automatic drinkers, I had to import them from China through the Alibaba. So it was very, very expensive. The tax, the shipping, everything was very expensive. And I had to do that because I needed to go to another level. And still, even today, I need more equipment, but they are very, very expensive. Maybe you go for an incubator at a price of around $40,000. You see, it's a lot, and there's no any person who can sponsor you to have that thing. So it's very challenging. So what I was trying to say, the government and government, what should the government do is to lower the taxes, to remove the taxes, like to make this thing. You don't have to pay the taxes, so a young farmer can access these stuffs at a very low price. And another thing that I think organizations like people who are here inside, we should help young farmers from Africa to create cooperatives, organizations, which is easy for them to have access to financial institutions. They can have access to crowdfunding platforms and everything. So once we do those two things, once we empower young people with financial assistance, and the second thing, when we modernize agriculture, very definitely we can see changes in agriculture.
Okay, thank you, Sirjeff.